Even suppose we are having one array and array is having these elements. Fine. Now we are going to apply, we are going to sort the data in ascending order, applying heap sort, and we are going to use here max heap. Now two steps would be there in heap sort. First step is you are going to create a heap, or you can say you are going to build a max heap. Next step is you are going to delete data from max heap one by one. Okay, and after deletion of all the data, you find out that the array is sorted in ascending order. Now first step, build a max heap. Now how we are going to build a max heap, how data is to be inserted in max heap, that processor I have already discussed in the previous video. You can check out that link in the description box. Now see, first element is 15. So in the tree we have only one element, that is 15. So it is a max heap by default, because no child element would be there, only one element is there, then obviously it is a max heap. Fine. Next element is 20. Now where the data is to be inserted? We have 15. Now where 20 to be inserted? To the left of this 15. Because see, this heap tree is a almost complete binary tree. Okay, and the data in the complete binary tree in the last level data should be as left as possible. So we are going to insert to the left of this 15, not to the right of this 20, because we cannot leave this place empty. We are supposed to fill this left side first. After that you can fill right side. So now after insertion of 20, this is the tree. Now you have to check, is it satisfying the max heap property? Because after each insertion you are going to check, is it still a max heap or not. Have to check the data to be inserted is 20. Now find out parent of this 20. Parent of 20 is 15, and 15 is less than 20, and that is not possible in max heap. So we are going to swap, because in max heap parent would be always greater than or equal to its child. So here swapping would be done. So here we will write 20 and here we will write 15. Now it is max heap. Next element is 7. Now where 7 is to be inserted? Here we have 20, 15. 7 would be inserted first of all to the right of this 20. Fine. See, we cannot insert 7 here. Why so? Because is it this heap tree is also a almost complete binary tree, and in complete binary tree all the levels except possibly the last level should be completely filled. So if you insert 7 here, so this is the last level, so these levels should be completely filled, but this level is not completely filled. This is having only one child here, right child should be there. So first of all, so we cannot insert 7 here, we have to insert 7 it this place. Fine. Now check, is it still satisfying max heap property after inserting 7? Find out the parent of 7, that is 20. 20 is greater than 7. Fine, no swapping would be done, it is max heap. Insert 9, 20, 15, here we have 7. So this level is completely filled. Now 9 would be inserted to the left of this 15. Here we will insert 9. Now check out parent of this 9 is, after every insertion you have to check, is it still satisfying the max heap property or not? Parent of 9 is 15, and 15 is greater than 9, so it is a max heap, no need to do any swapping. Next is 30. Here we have 20, 15, 7 and 9. Now where this 30 would be inserted? To the right child of this 15. Here we have 30. Now again check, find out the parent of this 30. Parent of 30 is 15, and 15 is less than 30, and that is not possible in max heap. Now you have to do what? Swapping. 30 would go up, so here you will write 30, and 15 would go down, here you will write 15. Now 30 is here. Now you are not done with this. You are supposed to check this with its parent. We will keep on checking this inserted element with its parent till we reach to the root element. Fine. We have already discussed this concept in when we were discussing max heap insertion. Now again find out parent of 30. Now parent of 30 is 20, and 20 is less than 30, so that is not possible. Again we will do what? Swapping. So here 20 would be there and here 30 would be there. Now 30 is the root element. Now we are going to stop this comparison, because 30 is not having any parent node now. Fine. So this is now our max heap after inserting this data. Now this is our max heap. Now that array would be, this array has been updated. Now array would be something like this. you can how do you can represent this tree into this array form? We have first element is 30, then we have 20, then we have 7, level by level and from left to right. Then we have 9, then we have 15. Array name is A and index is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Right? Like indexes are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now this is the array now. Now second step is, first step is over, building a mixheap. Next step you are supposed to delete data from mixheap one by one. How data is to be deleted, that we have already discussed with example. Always the data from root element would be deleted from a heap. You cannot delete any data from the heap, always the root element would be deleted. In mixheap, the root element would be the largest element. Fine. Now, next step is deletion. So, after deletion, the tree would be something like this. Here we have 20, here we have 7, here we have 9 and here we have 15 and here we have 30. So we have deleted this 30, right? Now which element is there? Which element is to be placed here instead of this 30, because we have deleted the root element. Now always we used to put the last element. The last element in this tree is 15, or you can say the last element in this array is 15. Fine. So 15 would be shifted here. Now here we will write 15 and 15 would be deleted from here. Okay. Now this, in this array, how array is to be updated, 15 is inserted here and we have deleted 30 and you are going to sort this array. So now see, now heap is from here to here. Now this space is free. So the deleted element would be placed here. Now we will place 30 at this place. In the tree also you can draw something like this. Here you can put 30. Okay, but I am not going to put 30 here. I am just updating the array. I am deleting 30 from here. Now this is the tree. Now after the deletion, it's not like that deletion is done, now delete next element, that is 15. No, after each deletion you have to check, is this tree still satisfying the property of max heap or not? Check out. This is the element which we have shifted from last to here. Now you have to check from here. Now find out the children of this element. We have two children, one is this one and one is this one, right? Now check out which one is larger, that is 20. Now 20 would be compared with this 15. Now this 15 is parent and parent is less than its child, and that is not possible in max heap. Now you have to do what? Swapping. Now 20 would go up and 15 would go down, right? So here we will write what? 20, and here we will write 15. Now here we have 15. Now see, it's not done. We have done one swapping and we are done with this. No, again you have to find out this left and right child of this 15. And till we reach to the last level, to the end of the array, until then you will find out the left and right child. Fine. I'm going to write down the code also. Now 15, left child is 9. We don't have any right child. Okay. Compare with this one. 15 is parent, 9 is child, and 15 is greater than 9, and that is fine. No swapping would be done. So this is now max heap. Fine. Now next element would be 20. 20 would be deleted. Now see, we have updated in this tree. When you are going to update in this array, then how this array would be updated? See, 20 would go there and 15 would go there, right? After this updation in this array, this would be the array now. Now next element to be deleted is this 20. Now after deletion of this 20 would be deleted here. Now next 20 would be deleted. Now we have deleted this 20, and the place of this 20 we will shift which element? The last element is 9. So 9 would be shifted here, right? And if you are going to update in this array, then 20 would be deleted. This last element in this array is now heap is from 1 to 4. 9 would be shifted here and we will shift this 20 here. Now this heap would be from 1 to 3. Size has been reduced again by 1. Fine. Now again check, because of this, after because of deletion of this 20, we have this tree now. Now check, this is max heap or not. This is, we have inserted this 9 at the starting. Now find out, right, the children of this 9. Two children are there, 15 and 7. Which one is larger? 15. 15 is compared with this 9, and this 9 is less than 15, and that is not possible in mixed heap. So now swapping would be done. 15 would go up, 9 would go down. So here you will write 9 and here you will write 15. The array would also be updated, right? 9. How this right child and left child is to be calculated, we know the formula. I value is 1, so the left child would be 2 into I, that is at second index. Right child would be 2 into I plus 1, that is at third index. 15 and 7 are two children of this 9. Which one is greater? 15. 15 is compared with this 9, and 9 is parent, which is less than its child. That is not possible, so we are going to shift. So 15 would go here and 9 would go here. Now this is the updated array. This is max heap now. Fine. Next element would be deleted, that is 15, right? So 15 would be deleted. Now instead of, at the place of this 15, which element is to be there? The last element. Last element in this tree is 7, or you can say the last element in this array is 7. So 7 would go here, and now the array size has been reduced, and we shift 15 at this place, right? So now 7 would go here. Now we have only two element in this heap. Now again check, find out the parent, the child of the 7. Child is 9, and 9 is greater than 7. That is not possible, so we are going to do swapping. So 9 would go up and 7 would go down, right? Here also, after swapping, what is the array? 9 would go here and 7 would go here. Okay, now next is 9 would be deleted. Now after deletion of this 9, which element is to be shifted here? Only one element is left, 7. So after deletion of this 9, we shift 7 at root node. Same in array, how you will update? We will delete this 9, and the last element in this array is, because array size is now this only. Okay, last element is 7. So we shift 7 here. Now the heap is from having only one element. So we'll shift 9 at this place. And now we have only one element, and that one element is always, you can say, at a max heap. So after deletion of this 7, we are going to delete 7, and obviously no one element is there. We are going to place 7 here only after deletion. Fine. So this is now the array. This is now the array after deleting all the element one by one. So see, you can say that this is sorted now, 7, 9, 15, 20 and 30. So this is how we are going to do sorting. Two steps. First, building of a max heap. Next, we are going to delete data one by one from the max heap. And after deletion of all the elements, you will get the array sorted. Now see the time complexity. I have already discussed, to insert an element, the time taken would be order of log n. Fine. Because to insert, we are going to insert an element at the last only, and maximum we are going to that compare that element with upper element, with its parent, then with its parent, according to the height we are going to compare. And height of a complete binary tree is log n. So to insert any data in the complete binary tree, in the worst case the time taken is order of log n, and we are going to insert n element. So for insertion, the time complexity would be order of n log n. And for deletion also take one element to be deleted, and that element take how many time? Order of log n. And you are going to delete n elements, all the elements you are going to delete. So for deletion also, it is going to take order of n log n. So total time complexity would be order of 2n log n, and by default 2 is constant, so you will write order of n log n. So time complexity of this heap sort is order of n log n, both in worst and best case, and in average case also. Fine. Now see, this building of this max heap here is taking order of n log n time. Can we apply some another method? In that case, the time complexity is only order of n. Because if you apply this method, then time complexity would be order of n log n. It is just for building the mix heap, creating the mix heap. But now we are going to discuss another method in which that building of mix heap will only take how much time? Order of n only. And obviously order of n is better than n log n, right? And that method is known as heapify method. Now we are going to discuss what is heapify method and how this method, heapify method, can be used in heap sort. So now I will discuss heapify method, or I can say mix heapify method, because I am taking into consideration the mix heap. How heapify method is used to build mix heap. Fine. Let us take this array we have. Now we have just represented this in the form of this complete binary tree. This is complete binary tree. According to this, this is the array. But this is not a mix heap. You are supposed to make it mix heap using heapify method. If you use the method, the first method we have discussed, that insertion method, then what we will do, first 15 would be inserted, then 5 would be inserted, and then checking with this parent, then 20 would be inserted, then checking with its parent, then 1 would be inserted, then checking with its parent and swapping, checking with parent and swapping, and like this. Then 17, then this 10, and then this 30. But here, now we are not going to do this thing. We are going to use heapify method. Now, what is that method? See, first of all, see, in the case of insertion, we have started from here. Now, let us suppose we have changed our approach and we have started from here. First is 30. Here, see, this 30, only check this 30. 30 is only one element. So, if only one element is there, and that element is itself a either mix heap or min heap. Here, we are discussing mix heap. So, the 30 is a mix heap. Now, check for 10. 10. Is 10 having any child node? We are going to check the descendants. We are not going to check the parent here. We are changing our approach. Fine. 10. Check only 10. 10 is also, you can say, not having any child element. So this is itself a mix heap. Then 17. 17 is also one element. This is itself a mix heap. Then we have 1. 1 is also one element. No child node is there. So it is itself a mix heap. Fine. Now we will check for 20. Now we have this one, 20, 20 is having left child and right child also. Now our main motto is to make this tree 20, 10 and 30 as mix heap. Fine. Then we will consider 5 and then finally 15. Okay, now check. 1, 17, 10 and 30, these are leaf nodes. So we can say if leaf nodes are there, then these nodes are itself mix heap. No need to heapify those nodes. You can say something like this, right? So we need to apply heapify method only on non-leaf node, right? And we are not going to start from here. We are going to start from right to left. So first of all, we are going to apply our heapify method to the non-leaf element, which is at the largest index. See, here index are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now at index 4, 5, 6 and 7, all the nodes are leaf node. So just leave those nodes and we are going to start our loop, or we are going to start our heapify method from 20 only. And index of 20 is 3. The non-leaf node are on the index 1, 2 and 3. So the largest index is 3, which is having the non-leaf node. So we are going to apply our heapify method from here. The non-leaf element, which is at the largest index. Fine. Now how to find out which index we are having leaf node, and from which index non-leaf node is going to start, from which the largest index non-leaf node is going to start. So in a complete binary tree, the property of complete binary trees, the leaf node would be from n by 2 floor value plus 1 to n. Here you can check, here n value is 7, 7 by 2 is 3.5, floor value is 3, 3 plus 1 is 4. So from 4 to 7, 4, 5, 6, 7, these are leaf node. As you can see in tree, 4, 5, 6, 7, these are leaf node. Suppose if I add one more element here. See, this tree is not still a mix heap. We are going to heapify this to make it a make C. So suppose we have inserted 9 here. Now leaf node are at the index 7 and here we have 8. Suppose here we have inserted this. In the array we will insert 8 here at the 8th index. Now n value is 8. Now 8 by 2 that is 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. From 5 to 8 we are having leaf node. So from 5 to 8. 5, 6, 7, 8. In the trick also you can see. So this is the formula. Leaf node would be from here to here. Now we are going to start our heapify method from the non-leaf element which is at the largest index. So from where we are going to start, we are going to start from n by 2. See, here n is 8, 8 by 2 that is 4. Go to the 4th index. At 4th index we have 1. In the tree also you can say this are leaf node. And non-leaf node is starting from index 4. This is the largest index, right? And if you delete this 9, this was our original tree. So I'm going to delete this 9. Now here n is what? 7. 7 by 2. Integer value we are going to take 3.5. We are going to take now 3 only. Go to the index 3rd, that is 20. Here check. We are going to start our heapify method from here only. So in this case heapify method would be started from n by 2. One variable we are going to take and from here only we are going to start that variable, and that variable would be decremented. After 20 we are going to check 5. So 5 is at index 2. So we are going to decrement that variable. Again we are going to decrement and we have reached to the root node. Till we reach to the root node. If you are going to take here index from 0, then here you will write n by 2 minus 1. We are going to start our heapify method from n by 2 minus 1. So let us start to apply our heapify method. See, we are going to apply from here. Now we are going to make this tree as a max heap only, because index is 3. We are going to start from here only because these are leaf node. No need to apply heapify method here because these are itself a max heap. Now find out child of this 20. One is 10, one is 30. Compare with this 10. This one is not larger than this parent, but 30 is greater than this parent. So we are going to swap. 20 would go down, 30 would go up. So after swapping, this tree would be 30 and 20, right? Here also you are going to swap this 20 and 30. So here you will write what? 30, and here you will write 20. See, here I value is 3. Find out the left child and right. Left is 3 into 2, that is at 6th index, and right would be at 7th index. So here which one is greater? 30. 30, compare 30 with 20. So obviously 20 is less than, parent is less than, so that is not possible. So we are going to swap these two. Now array would be something like this. Here we will write 20, here we will write 30. Fine. Now this variable would be decremented. Now I is at this place at 2. Now we are going to check this one. You have to make this as a max heap. Fine. Now check. 5. Find out left child and right child. 1 is left, 17 is right. 5 would be shifted with this 17 because 1 is less than. So no need to do shift. 17 is greater than this parent. So we are going to shift. Here you will write 5. Here also you can say this left child of this is 2 into I is here. 2. Left is 2 into 2 at 4th index and right child would be at 5th index. Which one is larger? 17. 17 compare with this 5. So we are going to, 5 is less than 17. Which one is, that is parent and that is not allowed. So you are going to do what? 17 would be here and 5 would be at this place in the array. Fine. Now this variable would be decremented. We have now at 15. Now we are going to make this complete as a max heap. See, 15. This left is a max heap, this right is also a max heap, right subtree. Now we have added this 15. Now you have to make this complete as a max heap. Now find out left and right child of 15. 17 and 30. Which one is greater? 30. 30 is compared with 15. 15 is less. So we are going to shift. Here you will write 15 and here you will write 30. But we are not done here. We are going to do the same process till we reach to the this n value, n is 7. So now, child of this 15 is 10 and 20. Which one is greater? 20. 20 is compared with 15. So we are going to swap. Here you will write 20 and here you will write 15. Now there is no left and right child. We have reached up to this 7, at the end of this array. Now we are going to stop. Now this is our max heap. This is how we are going to apply the heapify method. From here only, from right to left. Okay. And this would take a time complexity of order of n. Fine. And see, here in the array, how you will update I is 1. So left child would be at 2, right child would be at 3. So at 2 we have 17 and right we have 30. Which one is greater? 30. 30 would be exchanged with this one. Here you will write 15 and here you will write 30. Then 15. 15 is at index 3. Left child of this 3 is at 6th and right child would be at 7th index. At 6th we have 10, at 7th we have 20. Which one is greater? 20. 20 is compared with again this 15. Now we are going to shift. Here we will write 15 and here you will write 20. Right? Now, find out left child of 15. 7 into 2, that is 14. But 14 index is greater than this n. So we are going to stop here. We are not going to apply heapify here. Fine. So after updation, the array would be something like this. Now this is max heap. First step is over. Using heapify method, we have built max heap. Now, the next step in heap sort is you are going to delete data. Always the root element would be deleted. Fine. Here also we are going to delete 30. We are going to swap this 30 with this 15. 15 would go here because last element in this array is 15. So 15 would go here, 30 would go here. Now, after 15 would go here, again you are going to apply heapify method because after inserting 15 here, this is no more a max heap. And you have to make it max heap. Now again apply heapify method. Now how we are going to write the code for this heapify method. So now I am going to write a piece of code for this heapify method. Or you can say max heapify method. I am going to take max heapify method on the array name is A. N is total number of elements. And one variable I am going to take I. At which? Index, I am going to call the heapify method. Fine. So now I am going to take the original tree. Now whatever we have considered at starting, so this is the original tree. Fine. So next we are going to take a variable, largest, name is largest, and I would be assigned to here. Fine. And after that I am going to calculate the left and right child for that I. Okay, suppose here I value is 3. I am going to call heapify method from here because these are leaf node. We are going to call the heapify method on non-leaf node and which is at largest place. So here I is equal to 3. Now at starting see, here we have I and I value is stored to the largest. So here only we have largest. I am going to consider this is the largest now. Now next was we are going to calculate the left and right child of this 20. Okay. Now how to calculate? Suppose L is equal to 2 into I, we know the formula, and R is equal to 2 into I plus 1. 2 into I value is 3. So 2 into 3 is 6. Here we have left and here we have R now. Fine. Now next step was you are going to compare this with this left and right also. Now you are going to write a while loop. While first we will check left should be less than or equal to n. Now suppose somewhere I is equal to 5 and so left child would be 2 into I, that is at 10th index, and here we don't have any 10th index. So this left and right both child would be up to this last index. So it should be less than equal to this n. N is here 7. So one condition would be checked, and we will check what is this left child greater than its parent. So here we will check name of array is A. A of this left is greater than A of largest, because largest is 20 now. I and largest both are pointing 20. Fine. If this is true, if this L is greater than this one, because this is parent now. So now you will do what? You will consider this. This is the largest. So we do what? So we do what? Now largest is equal to L. Fine. So this is done. Next you will check. This is only for left. Next also we will check for right, na? So again same while loop would be applied. While same condition, R should be less than equal to this N, size of this heap. And we will check A of R is greater than A of largest. If A of R, this right child, is greater than this one, because largest is at starting at this place. So we will consider what? This is the largest element. So we will do what? Largest is equal to R. So this is the closing of this while loop. Fine. And now, if suppose, like in this case, 10 is not largest, so this condition is not true, but 30 is greater than this 20. Yes, both the conditions are true. So now in this case, the largest, this largest would be shifted to here, because R value is here what? 7. We have calculated here 7. So now in largest, first of all, I was there, I value was there, but now R value 7, 7 is in the variable that is largest. So now here is the largest. So next step is what? We are going to swap 30 with 20, right? So now we are going to check if first of all, the largest element was same as I, but now largest has been updated. So now we will check if largest is not equal to I. It means it has been updated. Okay. So now we are going to swap. So now we are going to swap what? This with this. So you can say A of largest and A of I. Right? This with this one. This largest has been updated in this case now. And again, here only you are going to call, recursively you are going to call, again heapify method. Heapify on array A, N, and here you are going to pass the value of this largest variable. Fine. This is closed now, and here you can close this heapify method. See, now here again we have called this heapify method. So this we will discuss with the help of one example. See, after this swapping, this now this array is what? Here we have 30 and here we have 20. Fine. At this place now it is called. Now 17 would go up and 5 would go here. So now we are going to take a case when heapify method is called here only, when I value is 1. Then you will come to know the value of this heapify, recursive call of this heapify. Fine. See, here suppose I value is 1, N is we have 7, array is this A. Okay. Now we have I value here only. Here we have I. Largest I is equal to, this largest is equal to I, means I value would be stored to largest only. So here also we have largest. Okay, both I and largest is now same. At starting we are considering this is the largest element. Now next step is find out left and right child. Left child is 2 into I, that is 2 into 1. Here we have left and here we have right. Next step is check these conditions. Left is 2. 2 is less than equal to N. N is 7. Yes. A of left. A of 2 is 17. And A of largest. Largest is equal to this 1. And this one is 15. So 17 is greater than 15. Yes. In that case, what will happen? This largest is equal to L. So L value would be passed. L value would be assigned to this largest variable. So now the largest has been updated, and now here we have largest, right? Now we are going to check with right also, right child also. R value is 3, 3 is less than n, yes. A of 3 means value is what? 30, 30 is greater than A of largest. Now largest is what? This one, not I. Now largest has been updated. So largest is now 17, but 30 is greater than 17. So this condition is also true. Now what is done? Largest is equal to R. Now R value is assigned to largest. So now again largest would be updated, and here we have now, this is now the largest element, same as R. R value is 3, largest is also now 3. Fine. Now next step is you have to check. If largest is not equal to I value is still 1, largest value is 3. So this condition is also true. Then you will do what? Swapping of this 15 and 30. Swapping of A of largest with A of I. So now we will do what? 30 would go up and 15 would go down. Right, but we are not done yet. We are going to calculate again left and right child of this one till we reach to the end. Fine, that is why we are recursively calling this hippify method here. Now we are going to call hippify at this point array n and largest value is what? 3 now. So largest is 3 now, so that is why we are going to pass largest here we are, that is why we are going to pass here largest value. So now here we are going to pass a, n and largest. So largest value is now 3, so 3 would be passed. So now I value is 3. So now again here we have I has been updated, and here also we have largest. Fine, calculate L value. 2 into i, 3 into 2, that is 6. Here we have L and here we have now R. Again check same condition. Left 6, 6 is less than 7, yes. And A of L value is 10. Is 10 greater than A of largest? Now largest value is here now, this one. 10 greater than 15? No. So control will not go to this loop. Again this while loop. Check for right child. R is less than 7 is less than equal to 7. Yes, this condition is true. And A of R is 20. 20 is greater than A of largest. Largest value is 15. So is 20 greater than this 15? Yes, this condition is also true. Now control will go to this loop. Now largest is equal to R. R value is here what? 7. So now 7 would be passed to largest. Now largest has been updated, and here we have now largest. Okay. Now check, if largest not equal to I is equal to 3 still, and largest is 7. So this condition is also true. Largest has been updated. Fine, because this right child is having value greater than parent. So next step is what? We have to do swapping. Swapping of A of largest with A of I. Now we will do what? 20 would go up and 15 would go down. Swapping. Again, hippify method would be called here only. A, N and largest. Largest value is 7. So now 7 would be passed. Now I value is this, and largest is also at this place because I is equal to largest. Now calculate L value. 2 into I, 7 into 2, that is 14, and this is 15. Now check, is 14? Now in this case L value is 14 and right value is 15. Now check, is 14 less than equal to 7? No, this condition is not true. Control will not go to this loop. Is R value 15, 15 less than equal to this n? No, this condition is also not true. So here we'll check, largest not equal to I, so that condition is also not true. No swapping would be done, and now this is done. Now we are not going to call this hippify method. Fine, because control will not go to this loop. Control will not go within this if condition, because this condition is not true. So then hippify method will not be called. Now we will stop to call hippify method because we have reached at the end. So this is how max heap would be built using this hippify method, and the time complexity using this is order of n. In heap sort you can use this hippify method, and if you are going to write down the code for heap sort, then how you will write? Two step would be there in heap sort. First building of max heap, next deleting. In building also you will call this method, second in deleting also you will call this method. Now how to write down that code? So now you can write like heap sort array, you can pass here array and total number of elements. And first step in heap sort is build a max heap. For building max heap, from where you are going to call heapify method? I have already told you, from n by 2, from the known leaf node which is at largest index. Fine. So we are going to write a for loop for I is equal to n by 2. I should be greater than, we are going to call first of all at 3, then 2, at 1 till we reach to the end. I should be greater than equal to 1 and I minus minus. Here we are going to call this method, heapify method. Array, we are going to pass this n and we are going to pass I, right? Now this step is just for building. Now next is deleting. Fine. Now deleting would be done from the root always. So now we are going to call one for loop again, and this I would be n. I should be greater than equal to 1 and I minus minus. So here see, this step is what? Build max heap, this for loop, right? And after that, next step is what? For deleting element from max heap. Fine. So for deleting, when you delete element, suppose we are going to delete this 30, then what we have done, we are going to swap this element here only. Fine. And the array, the heap size would be reduced to minus 1, and the last of the array, this space is free. Now we are going to, the deleted element would be shifted to here only. Fine. So here you can write, we are going to swap array of first this element with array of I, because I is n. So n means the last element. Fine. And after swapping, what we will do, we will check, is this still satisfying max heap property? If not, we are again going to make it max heap by calling this heapify method. So now here also we will call, see here we have taken name max heapify, so I am going to write here max heapify. So here also I am going to call max heapify on array A, number of elements are n, and here the I value would be passed, what here we are going to pass 1. And this step is for deleting, and after that you are going to close this heap. So this is what heap sort is. Here two questions are there. I hope you know that why I am going to start this loop from n by 2 in building of max heap. But this for deletion also I am going to start this loop from n, and here I am going to pass 1 only. So here pause the video, try to find out the answer, and if you get the answer, then please tell me in the comment box. Okay, here I am going to discuss why this, we are going to start this loop from n, and why this is here 1. Okay, see after building of this max heap, the array would be something like this. Here is 30, 17, 20, 1, 5, 10 and 15, right? Index is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now we are going to delete the data. Now in deletion, what we will do, we will swap, what we'll delete 30 from here. The last element would be shifted here. Now the heap size is from 1 to 6, and this is the blank space. So we are going to shift 30 at this place. Right? So that is why the swap is there. Now again we are going to call this heapify method. Fine. After heapify method, next largest element would be here at first place. It means 20 would be at this place now. Now again you will delete 20, and 20 would be stored here, and the element which is there at the last position would be shifted here, and again the size would be reduced. Okay. So now that is why I am going to start the loop from n, here only, because here the size is to be reduced from here only. First 7, then 6, then 5, and till we reach to 1. We are going to delete data till we reach to 1. That is why I am going to start this loop from 1. If you start this I from 1, then what you will do? You will do I minus minus, then next time I will be 2, next time I will be 3. So from here you are going this side. No, but in deletion you have to do what? You have to reduce the size from array heap size from this side. We are going from right to left. Fine. And now why we are going past one here? Because always we are going to call this heapify method at this place only. Because if you delete this 30, then you are going to pass, you are going to place 15 here. And you will check, because of this 15, is it violating max heap property? So now we are going to call max heap heapify method on here only, on the root node only, because always we are going to delete data from the root node. That is why always we are going to pass here 1. Always the heapify method would be called at this place, at root only. Okay, so this is now heap sort is, this is heapify method. The time complexity or time taken for this heapify method to build a max heap is order of n. Fine. And the time complexity of heap sort is what? Order of n log n. This is just for this heapify method, order of n. So in next video, I am going to discuss with you radix sort. Till then, bye bye. Take care.